the chairman and the faculty and the management of Oxford Medical College for giving me an opportunity to interact with all of you today. I may be repeating myself, especially for some of the faculty members who heard me before. Next 15 minutes, the interaction is entirely going to be between me and the graduating students. I assume that only we are here and nobody else is here, because some of the things what I am going to say, they may not like to hear. First of all, I want to start off saying, want to be successful. And we in India have a very clear image of who becomes successful, especially in the eyes of the parents. First of all, I would like to congratulate, all the gold medalists. They strived very, very hard. There is no doubt that they will be extremely, extremely successful. The toppers of the college will always be successful. But what about the rest? The rest of the students who didn't get the gold medal, they didn't get the highest marks, maybe they failed a few times. What happens to them? The parents and the society thinks that if they are not the shining stars of the college, they have no future. But the reality is different. The reality is the world is at the feet of the backbenchers. I am not saying that the gold medalists and the toppers don't succeed. They will succeed, they are guaranteed to succeed. But do not write off the backbenchers. Because historically, people who changed the world, who thought different, made things differently for the civilization to progress, are generally the backbenchers. So now you'll be wondering which bench I was occupying. Now, what makes you successful from now? I just want to start your journey saying that you are no different than the others. You are all starting at the same starting point of a long marathon race. Now, what is the first thing in your mind? The first thing in your mind is the NEET and getting into a PG. It doesn't matter whether you get MD, MS, DNB, FRCS, MRCP, they are all the same. I've been practicing for the last 35, 40 years in different parts of the world. No patient ever asked me my degree certificate or what degree I have. So it doesn't matter whatever route you take up. The first thing is to have an open mind. Never say that I want to do MD medicine in AIIMS Delhi. Yes, it is a prestigious thing. But when it is a question of relationship between you and the patient, and that's what matters. It doesn't matter whether you came from AIIMS or any other medical college. So this is the first lesson I would like you to learn. Work very, very hard. Try to crack the NEET exam. But don't keep away from the patients. I understand you need to mug a lot to pass the NEET exam, but always work every day, at least for a few hours on the bedside. If you can't get into PG in India, doesn't matter. Appear for the plan and go to England, go to US, go to Australia, go wherever you want. Get the knowledge, but always come back to this country. No other country will give you the kind of a recognition and the love and the affection as this country. Can I have the next slide? Can somebody change the slide? Next slide, please. Next slide. Next. A lot of the time you hear your teachers always telling you that today's students are not serious about studies, they don't do their homework, they don't respect teachers. You all heard about it, right? Do you know who made the statement? Can I have the next slide, please? Hippocrates in 460 BC, he made the same statement that nowadays teachers are not respected by the students. So if your teachers ever say that, don't worry. It has always been historically, when you become teachers, you will say the same thing. I can tell you that. Next slide, please. I just want to give you a very simple message. It doesn't matter what family background you have, whether you are a man or a woman, or which country you are, always dream big. Always say that I'm going to change the world. Believe me, once you make up your mind that this is the route I am going to take and this is what I want to achieve, nothing will come on the way. This is what is the power of purpose. In this profession, remember that ultimately your success is entirely dependent on one thing, that is you and the patient. What the patient thinks about you. I changed my address 4 or 5 times. I went from England, I went to Calcutta, I came to Bangalore, changed my address. Wherever I went, patients followed me, and that is your strength. That will only happen by the number of hours you have spent and the kind of passion you have shown, kind of empathy you have towards them, and that's what matters. So never limit yourself in imagining what the future is. I always quote this example of the power of purpose, stating what Mahatma Gandhi could achieve. Mahatma Gandhi was perhaps 4 foot nothing. He was not the strongest man. He didn't come from the richest family. He was not a brilliant orator to keep the crowd spellbound. And he had no other virtues, but he mobilized 400 million Indians to fight to get their freedom when none of them experienced what freedom was, because they were slaves, their parents were slaves, their grandparents were slaves. They didn't know what freedom was. And he motivated them to fight for a cause whose meaning they didn't understand, but he could convince them to sacrifice their life for the freedom. How this is possible? It is not him, it is the purpose. This is the power of purpose. If, when you decide to take up your profession and become a successful doctor, if you say that I am here to treat people who cannot afford to pay my fees, this is what I want to achieve. It may sound as if the stupidest thing, that how can you treat people who can't afford to pay you? But if you say that I will somehow get paid for whatever I am doing, if you believe in it, I can tell you that the richest people will queue outside your office, because your song, your praise are not sung by the rich people. They feel I have paid for the care, he took care of me. But when you care for the poor people, they tell the message, send the message across. And this is the secret of success for all of you. Whatever you want to do, kids, whether you want to get a PG seat, whether you want to get the job in the priciest, the one of the best hospitals in the world, you keep trying, but never give up. Winston Churchill, at the most difficult period of fighting getting the world together and fighting against the tyrannical forces, it was an impossible task to fight against Hitler. But he succeeded. In the end, when everything was over and we emerged as winners, the media wanted to know from Winston Churchill, what is the secret of the success? And he gave one of the shortest speeches, that is, never, never, never give up. This is what I believe. I never gave up. Nothing in my life came on a platter. I worked for it. I had the best people helping me, and cosmic forces will when the purpose, your power of the purpose is so big that everything will find its way. You always feel that it's in any industry, any business, it is the toppers, MBAs, and all these talented people will rise to the top. The people who rise to the top in a hospital or administration or any industry are the ones who work a little bit more than the others. In the end, that's all that matters. You're going to fail, and believe me, you're going to fail more times than you succeed. But that shouldn't prevent you from doing things, because the safest surgeon, do you know who the safest surgeon in the world? The safest surgeon in the world is the one who doesn't operate. If you operate, somebody is going to die. But because 0.1% or 0.5% of the people are going to die, your treatment is going to fail, you're going to deprive 99.5% of the people who are going to survive and lead a normal life. So never be scared of the failure. I failed many times in my life. I failed FRCS exam 4 times, and the 5th time my wife refused to pay the fees because I was drawing £500 and the fees for the Royal College exam were £600. So she refused to pay the fees. But in the end, what matters is your relationship with the patients. It doesn't matter what else happens in your life. I read in the newspaper quite often, children, they fail in the exam, they take the extreme step of ending their life. Ending the life is a permanent solution for a temporary problem. All failures are temporary. It is a matter of time. Whether it's a financial loss, whether it is any reputation loss, whatever, you can always make up for it. Never say that this failure is end and I have no future. Nobody knows anybody's future. So never be scared of failure. Always dare to dream big and you will succeed. As young doctors, you're going to learn, go to work in many, many places. And as a young surgeon, I went to different parts of the world to learn things. As a surgeon, I always try to visit other operating rooms, watching other surgeons, how they operate. And that is how I learned and got my knowledge. Good number of the surgeons will teach you and you learn a lot from them. But there are many surgeons who will teach you how to do the operation better. There are a lot of surgeons who will teach you how not to do the operation when you watch them, because when they finish the heart operation, heart looks like dog's dinner. So you may not like to reproduce what they are doing. But on the whole, you will learn from everyone. I'm about to finish my talk. I don't want to bore you enough. My very important message to all of you. It doesn't matter how great doctor you become. It doesn't matter how much magic you have in your fingers. Doesn't matter how many people are waiting to be operated by you. Always be spiritual. Always believe in God. It doesn't matter which God. I'm not saying you should be religious, but be spiritual. Because as a surgeon who has spent more than 30 years, 35 years of my life operating on the heart, I can never say what is the final outcome of whatever I am doing, irrespective of how confident I am. I treat myself as an instrument in the hands of God. Like I have in my hand my scissors, forceps, needle holders, I am a similar instrument in the hands of God. I do my best and I will leave it to the God to decide what the outcome is. Because if I ever say that the patient survived and he went home because of my skill, what about the patient who didn't survive Am I taking the blame or am I saying I did a shoddy job? So no matter what you are, whatever procedure you are going to do, take a pause, pray to God. When you finish the operation, again take a pause, pray to God for taking you through the operation successfully. It doesn't matter what level of maturity or the seniority you have. Believe me, God is above all of us, and everything what you do, if you believe in God, He will protect you. My next important message to all of you, be tech savvy. It doesn't matter what specialty you have chosen, what specialty you are practicing, be tech savvy. If you are not tech savvy, the world will just ignore you. It is difficult, I understand, for you to, if you are averse to the technology, to learn. 25 years ago, when mobile phone was just coming, my wife kept telling me that this is going to be the future. You have to learn how to use the mobile phone. Those days, mobile phone had, for me, the mobile phone had only two buttons, one green button to take the call, red one to switch it off. And then the messages started coming. And my wife kept telling me that you should learn how to send messages and read messages. And initially I ignored, but then it became so common, my patients started sending me messages. So I started learning. And when your wife is teaching you how to use a new technology with the message, what do? So I started sending messages to my wife to practice how to send messages. So the first message I sent to my wife is, "Honey, I love you." And then she would respond saying that, "I love you too." And it went on for a few days, and she would check when I went home. One day I gave the phone and she checked it, and she threw the phone on the floor, started screaming. I said, "What happened?" She said, "You sent the message to you, I love you message to the matron of the hospital." So this kind of a thing do happen when you are learning technology, but there is no excuse. You all have to learn how to use technologies. I can tell you that in the near future, smart software will make smarter diagnosis than the doctors. And in a matter of few years, you will be legally mandated to take the second opinion from the software before starting the treatment. It is going to happen. Now, does that mean that you are going to be less important than the software? No. There is a very famous statement that AI is not, artificial intelligence is not going to replace the radiologist, but a radiologist who is going to use the artificial intelligence is going to replace the radiologist who do not use the artificial intelligence. So if you want to compete, if you want to be at the cutting edge, you need to learn how to use technology. And technology is becoming very, very friendly. All the EMRs of the world are gradually shifting to your mobile phone. You will be able to do your virtual rounds from home. In the near future, when you graduate as become specialist, believe me, most of the patients, first time consultation will happen online with patients at home, and you are at your home or wherever you are. When you enter a hospital, there will be a reception with no receptionist, because everything what a receptionist does will be done 1 or 2 days earlier by the receptionist at home and the patient at home. When you watch the intensive care unit will have no intensivist. They'll be at home, sitting at home, managing the ICU. And believe me, that will dramatically transform the way the intensive care units works. And most of the surgeries will be done with the robot. And this is not the prediction for the next century. This is going to happen in the next few years. And be prepared. And I just want to end my talk wishing you all the best with a very simple message that your future is lot more than the NEET. Your future is lot more than the PG degree you get. It is something different, and it is entirely up to you to choose the path. And my last message to all of you is that when you finish your graduation day program, go home and hug your parents and you tell them you love them. Because you always think that parents know we love them, but unfortunately they don't always express your views. We Indians have a problem in expressing our views. We Indians have a problem in hugging our parents in public. Express your views. Tell them how great, how much grateful you are to them, because you have no idea the sacrifice they have made for you. Good luck and God bless. Thank you. It is very, very important for all of you to have a nice attitude. We can always teach people the skill. I can teach a lot of the people to operate on the heart, but ultimately it is the attitude what matters. Now, what is the attitude for a young doctor or a young paramedic or a nurse? When the patient comes in front of you, doesn't matter how much you have a problem at home or the job front, your health front, whatever, always keep a smiling face. Always keep a smiling face, because they are in pain. They have come to you for relief. Never bring your mind, the what is going on in your mind, in front of the patient. And whatever happens, always reassure them that you're always there with them throughout their journey of caring. And irrespective of how bad the prognosis is, never reflect it on your face. When you're talking to the patient, always be optimistic. Can I have the next slide?